video we'll discuss about sublingual space infection. We have to write boundaries, contents, source of infection, spread, clinical features and management. Then coming to the boundaries, you can see in this diagram the muscle which differentiates sublingual space from the submandibular space is nothing but the mylohyoid muscle. In this diagram, this black colored one is nothing but the mandible, right? And this is the hyoid bone, and this red colored one is nothing but the mylohyoid muscle. And above that, we have the tongue along with the mucosa of the floor of the mouth. This blue colored one is nothing but the submandibular gland, and this is sublingual gland. So the space between the mylohyoid muscle and the floor of the mouth mucosa is nothing but the sublingual space. So this is the sublingual space area. From this, the superior boundary is nothing but the mucosa of the floor of the mouth. This one, mucosa of the floor of the mouth. Then inferiorly we have the mylohyoid muscle, this one, right? And medially we have muscles of the tongue, that is intrinsic muscles. You can see in this diagram. In this diagram, this is the mandible, right? And this is the mylohyoid muscle. This is the mucosa of the floor of the mouth. And this is the tongue. This is sublingual gland. So due to the carious teeth, which is perforated lingual cortex above the attachment of the mylohyoid muscle, will lead to the sublingual space infection. So the medial, this is the medial boundary and this is the lateral boundary. Medially we have the tongue, that means intrinsic muscles of the tongue. And laterally we have medial aspect of the mandible, nothing but this one. This is the buccal aspect and this is the skin, this is the medial aspect. So laterally we have the medial aspect of the mandible. And anteriorly also the same, medial aspect of the mandible. Both laterally and anteriorly it is nothing but the medial aspect of the mandible. You can see in this diagram, this is the anterior boundary, right? That is mandible. And posterior boundary is nothing but the medial portion of the submandibular gland. Medial portion or superior portion or posterior portion of the submandibular gland. So to remember the boundaries, just remember M letter. Every boundary starts with the M letter. You can see here. Superiorly, mucosa of the floor of the mouth. Inferiorly, mylohyoid muscle. And medially, we have the intrinsic muscles of the tongue. And laterally and anteriorly, we have medial aspect of the mandible. Posteriorly, we have the medial portion of the submandibular space. This is regarding the boundaries. Then coming to the contents, you can see in this diagram, this is also the lingual aspect of the mandible. This is nothing but the mandible, which is lingual aspect. And this is the hyoid bone. So this blue colored one is nothing but the geniohyoid muscle that originates from the genial tubercles and inserts on the hyoid bone. This red colored one is nothing but the mylohyoid muscle, which forms the floor of the mouth. So in this diagram, the above space, above the mylohyoid muscle is nothing but the sublingual space. So this is the sublingual space on left side and this is on the right side. When you are coming to the contents, there are three contents. One is, this is nothing but the sublingual gland and this is some part of the deep lobe of the submandibular gland along with the submandibular gland duct, that is Wharton's duct, right? And third content is nothing but the lingual nerve. This is the lingual nerve and this is nothing but the going into the inferior alveolar canal. This is mandibular foramen. So there are only three contents: lingual nerve, sublingual gland and submandibular gland along with the duct. Then source of infection. The primary source of infection is nothing but the mandibular premolars and mandibular first molar. Mandibular premolars and mandibular first molar. The root apices of these teeth are above the mylohyoid muscle attachment. Right? So this is the mylohyoid muscle. So mandibular first molar is nothing but this one. And this is the mandibular second premolar, this is the mandibular molar, the mandibular first premolar. The root apices of these teeth are above the mylohyoid muscle insertion. So that will lead to the sublingual space infection. Then coming to the spread, that means from sublingual space infection, it can go to the opposite side space. Generally, usually the both side sublingual spaces are affected. Because only loose connective tissue separates the two sublingual spaces. So a space infection can easily cross to the opposite side. So first spread is opposite sublingual space. Then submandibular space. Submandibular space, sublingual and submandibular space are connected at the posterior border of the myeloid muscle. You can see here. This is the myeloid muscle. So at the posterior border of the myeloid muscle, the sublingual space and submandibular space are interconnected. So infection can easily go into the submandibular space. Then lateral pharyngeal space, that is posterior spread of the infection. You know that the pharyngeal wall is formed with the constrictor muscle, superior constrictor and middle constrictor. In between these, the styloglossus muscle passes, right? That creates a gap that is called as buccopharyngeal gap. From that buccopharyngeal gap, infection can courses posteriorly to involve the lateral pharyngeal space. Then epiglottis. Infection from the sublingual space can easily travel through the intrinsic muscles of the tongue to involve the epiglottis. This is one dangerous sign, that is epiglottis. Epiglottis involvement. Then it may involve the submental space also, anterior. These are the spread of an infection. Then coming to the clinical features, the most obvious feature is nothing but the brawny erythematous tender swelling of the floor of the mouth. Swelling of the floor of the mouth. That is brawny. That is woody hard. It is non-pitting. That is somewhat firm swelling. Then elevation of the tongue and unable to protrude the tongue beyond the vermilion border of the upper lip. This is chairside test to diagnose sublingual space is involved or not. If the patient is able to protrude the tongue beyond the vermilion border of the upper lip, then there is not much involvement of sublingual space. If he is not doing like that, then it is the involvement of the sublingual space. It is the chairside test. Then dysphagia, that is painful swallowing, and epiglottitis, that is swelling of the epiglottis along with the abscess formation. These are the main clinical features of the sublingual space infection, right? Then coming to the management, routinely give antibiotics, analgesics, as usual, same thing. If the patient is toxic, then you have to give the hydration therapy also, hydration therapy and other supportive therapies, right? When there is well localized abscess formation, then you have to go for incision and drainage. That can be done intraoral approach or by the extraoral approach, right? Intraorally, we have to place an incision close to the alveolar border. In this diagram, this is the abscess formation. So in this case, we can give the incision in the oral mucosa like this. We have to incise the mucosa of the floor of the mouth close to the alveolar border, and it should be parallel to the Wharton's duct to avoid injury to the sublingual gland and Wharton's duct also. From that you can bluntly dissect and you can completely drain the pus in the sublingual space. That is the intraoral method. In extraoral method, that means extraoral method is generally used when there is simultaneous involvement of the sublingual space along with the submandibular or submental space. If there is involvement of the sublingual and submental space, you can place an incision at the lower border of the mandible in chin region, and you can blindly dissect, and you have to pierce through the myeloid muscle fibers. Then you can directly drain the sublingual and submental space also. When there is sublingual and submandibular space involvement, then you have to place the incision at the approximately at the angle region, right? Just front, in front of anterior to the angle region. Again, same, you have to pierce through the myeloid muscles, right? That means this area. We have to pierce through this myeloid muscle, and you can drain completely sublingual and submandibular space infections also. After drainage, you can place a rubber drain, and you have to suture the incision site. This is regarding the incision and drainage. This is all about the sublingual space infection. The easiest thing is the boundaries, right? You have to remember the M letter, that's all. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.